Yeah, for all the ones that have to work in the garden for I don't know how long a day, you know, you might have a tool shed exactly looking along these lines, you know, that's what it's supposed to look like. So if you want to clean this shit out really nice, really easy, and maybe even quick, depends on your skills, you should get some whatever the fuck this is. It's apparently drinkable. It's some liquid nitrogen. Yeah, that's the stuff. You get one of these little potties, you put one on the table. Handle with care. Yeah, it says handle with care. Look at that. There we go, nice and easy. So you put one on the table. And when that one is on the table, you take a bit of gasoline, you know, to throw into your car and you smash the hell out of it. Along these lines. And as you shall see. God fucking. There we go. Yeah, about right. No, not yet. This is the real way to clean your shit, you know. Just set it on fire. There we go. And when you finally get back from hospital, your shit should look along the lines of, you know, when wife cleaned. There we go. It's supposed to be clean, you know. It's clean as hell, isn't it? Yeah. Very, very clean. A bit of fire, you know. Get a fire extinguisher of some sort. All of them do, but you know, with fire what you fix, it's fire. Just put more fire on it, you know, a pressure cooker, since you need some goddamn tea, don't you? So to get the last bits out of here, and maybe a good cup of tea, just put a pressure cooker, you know, one of those singing kitchen maids, you know what I mean. Put them in there, close your doors, and count to three. There we go. You see smoke come out of your shed. Well, it should be about right, so you open your little garden shit, literally, and it is clean as hell. You should not mind those black stains on the floor, they are all decoration. They're extra decoration if they ask you. And if there is some blood on the ceiling or on the roof, why not? Just clean it off with a bit of lemon. Lemon cleans everything, including blood. You know, since that cleans shit. And when you wanna finish this bitch, and when you wanna make sure it doesn't get, you know, dirty again, you're gonna go to the military and probably even get to NASA. And maybe, just maybe, you should get a nuclear bomb. It depends on how big your shed is, but mine is pretty big, you know. Considering my house is that big, this is a really big one. So you take, what would you take? Of course, we take a cluster fucking nuke, because we want to make sure this thing doesn't return anytime soon. So the easiest way to get this cluster fucking nuke in here is open these two doors, like that, and just maybe make sure you don't activate it, because you know, it might hurt a bit if you're close. Now activate it. And just jam it in there. Yeah, there we go. Nice and easy. There we go. Oh, yeah, that just happened. And that's how to get rid of your goddamn shack. I am not responsible for any damage to that garden shed you try to clean. If wife dies or leaves you because Jake lost his arm, I am not responsible. If you think about suing me, contact me at 05-911-666-101. Ask for Mr. Right Butt Cheek. If it's not available, please check your sanity meter. And now, just bug off, or do I need to get my shotgun? Double barrel, so double trouble.